Our departure time is 0800. Get your bird started and I'll meet you at the runway.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, radio check.
One, copy.
Guided bombs have really made the A-10's job easier. You can drop them from outside the weapon engagement zone of AAA and man pads. And with IAMS, you can get out of dodge before the enemy even knows you're there. You can drop LGBs using CCIP, but normally they are dropped using CCRP from altitude. The key with LGBs is making sure that the programmed laser code matches the laser beam it is writing. Even with the laser aim point, it must be corrected for winds. Adjust the laser aim point 1 foot upwind per knot of wind determined. For strong surface winds, you may even have to aim off the target to record a hit. LGBs require a minimum of 8 seconds of guide time or the bomb won't guide to the target. Ensure you have enough altitude for a good guide time. The hard deck on the range will be 500 feet AGL. This is the foul line and you will fail this PO if you go below this altitude. And above all, make sure you positively ID the targets. We don't want to kill any friendlies today.
Pull up! Altitude!
Double Eddie, Colt 1-1. Request taxi to runway.
Colt 1-1. Double Eddie, clear to taxi to runway 25.
One.
Rolling.
Cabaletti, Colt 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt 1-1, Cabaletti, you are cleared for takeoff when ready. Climb 300 at QFE 29.81.
Rolling.
Your performance check starts now. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, fly heading 245, Angels 8, and maintain full speed. Hard deck limit is in effect. Do not go below Angels 5 unless the restriction is terminated. Approaching Angels 8. Level out and maintain appropriate speed. Good. Maintain 245, Angels 8, and appropriate speed. Use of the autopilot is authorized. Let's review the mission profile. Threat level is low, so this will be a high altitude profile. Your first target is at waypoint 5. This will be an LGB weapons delivery using the GBU-12s. You will self-laze all LGB drops. Your second target will be at waypoint 6. This will be a JDAM weapons delivery using the GBU-38s. Your third target will be at waypoint 7. Choose either the LGBs or JDAMs from your remaining GBU-12s or GBU-38s. Your last target will be a moving convoy near waypoint 8. Use the CBU-105 WIC mids on this target. You're permitted to finish any remaining targets using gun strafing. Let's review the air-to-ground training rules. Perform all delivery passes, including jettison passes, whether hot or dry, using live ordnance delivery parameters to include fuse arming, safe escape, safe separation, and flight deconfliction considerations. Avoid populated areas to the maximum extent possible when carrying externally loaded, heavyweight, inert, or externally internally loaded live ordnance. Prior to first release when carrying expendable ordnance, live, inert, or training, final switch configuration for weapon release not be accomplished until the aircraft is in such a position that any accidental release will be contained within the range. Do not conduct simulated attacks against off-range or manned targets with the internally externally loaded live ordnance or externally loaded heavyweight inert ordnance. This restriction does not apply to 20 or 30 millimeter ammunition, BDU-33s, 2.7-inch TP and SP rockets, or non-expendable training assets. The use of combat laser mode of laser designator is restricted to laser-certified ranges. All air-to-surface laser operation on range will be in accordance with range planning and operations and local range procedures. Knock it off can be called by anyone, and all must acknowledge. If you see it first, call it. This could be due to a training rule violation, loss of SA, out of control flight, radio failure, bingo fuel, or any other dangerous situation. Nordo aircraft will rock his wings to indicate the radio failure. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to 330, maintain Angels 8 at an appropriate speed. We will be maneuvering. We will do a G awareness test shortly after passing waypoint 2. Brevity code is G warm. This is important in assessing your G proficiency and getting back your timing and execution of the anti-G straining maneuver. Checking G suit and combat edge connections and operation. Recalibrating how you apply on onset and control at peak level aircraft G. Providing an exposure to the cardiovascular system to activate its reflex response to a drop in blood pressure. A maneuver of 3 to 5 G for about 10 seconds is required to fully develop this reflex response. The maneuver is not performed in order to test how many G you can pull that day. Don't G lock on the G awareness turn. Remember your anti-G straining maneuver. Anticipate the G. Simultaneously tense all lower body muscles, legs, butt, and abdominal muscles. Deep breath with forced exhalation against a closed airway. Quick breath every 3 seconds, once at peak G. Minimize communications. Don't relax until the G is unloaded. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to heading 065 and maintain Angels 8. Colt 1, Excel, G-warm. Colt 1, G-warm, 90 left. Go. Colt 1, G-warm, 90 right. Go. Colt 1, fence in. Colt 1, 2, fenced in.
Colt 1, 1, fence in.
SIF range control, Colt 1-2. Request clearance for Colt 1, flight of two A-10s west of entry Alpha. We have six GBU-12s, two GBU-38s, two CBU-105s, two AIM-9s, and 2,000 rounds of 30 Mike-Mike.
Colt 1-2, SIF range control, you're cleared at entry Alpha. You have the airspace from 500 to flight level 400. Weather is clear, visibility good in all quadrants. Authorized Colt 1-2 control.
Colt 1-2 confirms all altitudes, clear of clouds, hard deck 500. I have control. Let's review some information about the weapons you are using today. The GBU-12 Paveway 2 is the laser-guided bomb version of the Mark 82 unguided general-purpose bomb. It can be mounted on single or triple ejector racks. It has a glide range of 8 nautical miles and makes for a great tank blinking weapon. When dropping LGBs, it is critical to minimize laser spot movement so the bomb will not deplete energy below the minimum 8 seconds of glide time. Watch for other aircraft lasing targets with the same code. This bomb may guide on the wrong laser. The GBU-38 is a standard Mark 82 general purpose bomb fitted with a GPS guidance kit. The Joint Directed Attack Munition, or JDAM, kit turns the bomb into a significant standoff weapon. The GPS antenna at the rear of the bomb steers the tail surface to the target. It can strike through clouds, smoke, and fog, and it relies on a GPS signal for targeting, and not a laser detonator which can be blocked. It has an 8 nautical mile glide range and an impact accuracy within 33 feet. The CBU-105 is a CBU-97 sensor-fused weapon with a wind-corrected munitions dispenser, or Wickman tail kit. The weapon is guided by an internal navigation system, updated with GPS target data before release. The weapon consists of an SUU-66-B tactical munition dispenser that contains 10 BLU-108 submunitions. Each submunition contains 4 hockey puck-shaped sensor-fused projectiles called skeets. These detect target vehicles such as tanks, armored personnel carriers, trucks, and other support vehicles, and fire a kinetic energy penetrator at them. It has a glide range of 8 nautical miles and an impact accuracy within 30 feet.
2, contact target, 12 spots, point 1-2.
Know that JDAMs always target the speed. The technique for all JDAM deliveries
two,
is to enter the
target, target 12 spots, point 1-3.
Set that as the speed. Ensure the speed is set as the current steer
point. 2, contact armored target, 12 spots, point 1-3.
As the CICU has to send the speed coordinates to the JDAM and verify that they are the same before releasing the weapon. Hold the pickle button down until the weapon is released, or you risk a hung storm. The targets will be popping smoke to help you VID them.
2, contact target, 12 spots, point 1-3.
Call Tally once you locate the target visually. You have permission to engage. If you cannot locate the targets, you are permitted to circle the target area and re-engage if required. Do not stray outside the target range or MOA. You are at the IP. You are cleared in hot.
Colt 1-1 in hot. Colt 1-1
tally.
Colt 1-2, tally.
Bombs away.
That's a kill. Let's move to the next target.
Bombs away.
Colt 1-2, tally. Let's move to the next target. Colt 1-2, tap.
Bombs away.
Good pass. Re-engage.
Bombs away.
Colt 1-2, tally.
Colt 1-1, tally. Bombs away.
Good pass. Re-engage.
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 Guns, guns, guns! Guns, guns, guns!
Pull up! Pull up!
Guns, guns, guns!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Guns, guns, guns!
Pull up, pull up!
Guns, guns, guns!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Altitude, altitude.
Guns!
Pull up!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up!
Guns!
Pull up!
Guns!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up! Pull up! Pull up!
Guns!
Pull up!
Guns!
Pull up! Pull up!
Guns!
Pull up!
Good pass.
Pull up!
Re-engage.
Pull up!
Guns!
That's a kill. Time to egress.
Pull up!
Thank you. SIF Range Control, Colt 1-2. Requesting clearance north of Exit Bravo.
Colt 1-2, SIF Range Control, cleared for Exit Bravo. Have a nice day.
Colt 1-2, Roger, cleared for Exit Bravo. Colt 1-2, off, safe, visual. Colt 1-2, fence out. Colt 1-2, fenced out, 2-6. Hard deck restriction is terminated. You're permitted to land and shut down your bird. I'll give you a rating then.
Cavaletti, Colt 1-1, inbound.
Colt 1-1, Cavaletti, fly heading 08342, QFE 29.86, runway 25, to pattern altitude. Colt 1-1, cleared for visual, contact tower.
Cavaletti, Colt 1-1, request landing.
Colt 1-1, Cavaletti, clear to land, runway 25.
Altitude, altitude.
Take the taxiway to the right. You can park in the first free revetment on your left.
Congratulations! You passed this PO. You received a qualified Q rating. Well done. Return to Cobaletti for the next qualification mission.